We call her Ba by Subhadra Sen Gupta. In many photographs of Mahatma Gandhi, you will see her sitting right behind him. A small woman with delicate features, wearing a khadi sari. She was Kasturba, wife of Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi. Kasturba Gandhi was simply Ba or Mother. To all, just as Mahatma Gandhi was Bapu or Father. Kasturbai Makhanji Kapadia was born on 11th April 1869 at Porbandar in Gujarat. She was married to Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi in 1883. Kasturba would stand up to her husband, who would be quite bossy. He had to convince her before she listened to him. She would stand grimly silent, refusing to fight. And Gandhiji said that he got his first lessons of satyagraha from his strong-willed wife. Satyagraha and ahimsa were at the heart of our freedom movement. Satyagraha was the fight for truth and freedom, and it was to be achieved through ahimsa, which was non-violence. He said, "She ultimately made me ashamed of myself and cured me of my stupidity in thinking that I was born to rule over her. And in the end, she became my teacher in nonviolence." At the age of 27, the mother of two boys, Kasturba, boarded a ship in Bombay to travel to South Africa with Gandhiji. South Africa was ruled by white-skinned people who mistreated the Africans and Indians. The Africans and the Indians had no rights at all. This was the time when Gandhiji, a young lawyer, started a battle for the rights of Indians in South Africa and founded the Natal Indian Congress Party. Protest marches were held where many people, including Gandhiji, were arrested and jailed. The next protest was against a new law that said that only Christian marriages were legal. Kasturba was furious and protested against the law. She led a team of women into the province of Transvaal and was arrested and sent to prison. She was kept in a filthy cell for 3 months. Finally, the law was repealed. In 1915, the Gandhi family left for India to face greater challenges and a bigger struggle. Kasturba knew Gandhiji had come back to India with plans to join the freedom struggle. So, she was prepared for more hardships. Kasturba was now a freedom fighter. Gandhiji had been away from India for nearly 20 years, and the Congress leader, Gopal Krishna Gokhale, suggested that he should learn about his country first. So, he began a long journey of discovery by train, and Kasturba went with him. She was amazed at how the poor people greeted them with love everywhere. All that these simple people knew was that here was a leader who was ready to listen to them, fight for them, and was on their side. People in hundreds would be waiting for them at railway stations and would fill their compartment with flowers and fruit. Gandhiji then started the Sabarmati Ashram near Ahmedabad, and this was Kasturba's new home. Kasturba welcomed all the leaders of the freedom struggle there. For every freedom fighter, young and old, she was an understanding friend. The ashram had its own school and library. Gandhiji taught everybody at the ashram to grow fruit and vegetables, take care of the cows and goats, and spin cotton thread on charkhas to make saris and dhotis. Once, they had a charkha contest to see who could spin the most thread. And both Kasturba and Gandhiji lost to one of their granddaughters. Gandhiji told the kids that they should always obey Kasturba like he did because he was very scared of her. One day, after everyone had eaten lunch, Kasturba went off to have a nap. Just then, some guests arrived and Gandhiji wanted to give them lunch. But he did not want to disturb Kasturba. So, he told the children to cook some food but to do the cooking very quietly, making sure Kasturba did not wake up. And then he quickly left. Soon, disaster struck when one boy dropped a brass plate with a huge clang. It woke up Kasturba and she wanted to know why she had not been called. If Papu thought he could escape her anger, he was mistaken because she walked into his prayer meeting and gave him a scolding in front of many people. Gandhiji and Kasturba traveled together to Champaran in Bihar, where he tried out his satyagraha to help indigo farmers who were being ill-treated by white owners. They moved from village to village talking to people. Kasturba sat and talked to the women and tried to make them understand the need for cleanliness, good nutrition, and the benefits of educating their children. In the winter of 1930, Gandhiji and his followers began to prepare for the Dandi March in Champaran. Kasturba had decided to join the march. Even at the age of 60, she was not afraid of marching for weeks on rough country roads and facing police batons. After the march, Gandhiji was sent to prison and Kasturba began to visit the hospitals to help the people who had been injured in the protests. In 1942, the Congress Party passed a resolution asking the British to quit India. All the Congress leaders were arrested the same night and sent to prison. Gandhiji was taken to the Aga Khan Palace near Pune and Kasturba requested the government to allow her to join him. When they refused, she threatened to address a public gathering and lead a march. They had no choice but to allow her to stay with Gandhiji. Kasturba and Gandhiji shared this imprisonment for 2 long years. In 1944, Kasturba fell seriously ill with a lung infection. On 22nd February 1944, Kasturba Gandhi passed away. With Ba, it was as if a part of Bapu departed. Kasturba had fought and sacrificed so much, and it is unfortunate that she did not live to see India become free.